In this session, we are discussing bubble shot, very famous shorting algorithm. So in case of bubble shot, we know that shorting means we are arranging data either in the ascending or descending order. And we are having different shorting algorithm. Bubble shot is one of them. So let me discuss this bubble shot with the respective algorithm and with some examples. See, so let us suppose we are having n is equal to 6. 6 number of data we are having in this particular array, and here the array locations are ranging from 1 to 6, and the data which this particular array is having initially is 56, 47, 41, 35, 22, 11. You might be asking me, this data is already shorted in the descending order. Yes, the data is shorted in the descending order, that I know, but I have taken this one as an example due to some reason. What is the reason? I shall discuss that one later. And at the end, I am arranging this data in the ascending order. And in this algorithm, if I am having my data either in some unshorted order or any kind of descending or ascending order, then also ultimately I am going to get my data according to my logic in the ascending order. Okay. Here I have taken this data in the descending order due to some reason. Okay. Now, what is a bubble shot and how does it work? At first, the numbers, that is at the location number 1 and 2, they will get compared. And if the number 1, location number 1 is greater than the number at location number 2, then they will get swapped. You know swapping? Swapping means interchanging of the locations. The values will interchange their locations. So they will get swapped. Now they will be compared. So 56 is higher, so they have got swapped. They will be compared, 56 is higher, they have got swapped. 56 will be compared with 22, 56 is higher, so they will get swapped. 56 and 11 will be compared, as 56 is higher than 11, so 11, 56, they will get swapped. So this is my scan number 1. What is the result of scan number 1? The highest number out of these numbers will be found at the last place. That should be the case, because we are trying to arrange all these numbers in the ascending order. So now 47, 41 will be compared. 47 is higher, so that's why they will get swapped. 47 is higher than 35, so they will get swapped. In this way, the process has been continued. In the first scan, or at the end of the first scan, the highest number has been found at the highest place. After the second scan, the second highest number has been placed at the second highest place. So after the third scan, the third highest number at the third highest place. So in this way, the numbers have got shorted. We know that out of n number of numbers, if we can place n minus 1 number of numbers in the shorted form, then automatically the nth one will be found in the shorted form. So that is no need to put 11 separately, because it is already as a smallest number has been found at the least place number. That is the place number 1. So in this way, the logic is getting executed. Okay. Now see, how many scans did we require? I require 5 scans. So scan number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now tell me, how many gaps are there if we are having 6 lampposts? So when we are having 6 lampposts, so we will be having 5 gaps. So that means, if I am to compare in between 2 numbers, out of in between 6 numbers, then I shall be having 5 comparisons. So comparison number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 comparisons I shall be getting. So in the scan number 1, number of comparison will be 5. Scan number 2, number of comparison will be 4. Why? Because already it has been placed to the correct position. So I am remaining with the 5 data. So 5 data means, if we go on comparing in between the pair of adjacent numbers, then I shall be having 4 such comparisons. So now here 2 data have got placed to the correct positions. So I am remaining with 4. So 3 comparisons for that, 2 comparisons and 1 comparison, like this. Okay. So in this way, I have formed this particular tracing table. Why did I take this number in the descending order? So that in each and every step, I can show you a swapping for the better understanding. So that I can get my numbers at the end of the execution in the ascending order. So that's why initially I took numbers in the descending order. I could have took numbers in some unshorted way also, unshorted order also. Now see, how many scan did I require? 5 scan. What is 5? Tell me, what is 5? 5 means n minus 1. That is quite true, because out of n number of numbers, if I can place n minus 1 number of numbers in the correct position in the shorted order, then automatically the nth one will be placed in the desired place. So now, so here this particular range will be for I will be 1 to n minus 1. So that is my logic. So I will be n minus 1. Okay, now see. So it is 1 to n minus 1. So that is the logic I'm telling. Good. Now, in the first scan, number of comparison is equal to 5. In the second scan, it is 4. So how to correlate them? It is increasing, it is decreasing. So whenever something is increasing, subtract that number from some fixed data so that the difference value will be decreasing. So that is my logic. So if I go for 6 minus 1, 5, 6 minus 2, 4, 6 minus 3, 3. So it is nothing but n minus I. So this logic is n minus I. So how many scans? 5 scans. For each and every scan, how many comparisons? N minus I number of comparisons. So you are going to get a flavor of two nested for loops. One for loop will be the number of scans which will decide the scan number. There is an outer for loop, and the inner for loop will decide how many comparisons we require in that particular scan. So you are going to have two nested for loops here in the algorithm. So let us look for the algorithm. Algorithm bubble sort. Here I am passing only two parameters. One is the array name and the size of the array. Size of the array means the number of valid data deciding in the array. The array might be having bigger size, so that is not a point of concern. We are requiring the number of valid data inside the array. So that is n, say. So which loop will come outside? The number of comparisons or the scan number? Obviously, the scan number will be the outer loop, and for that particular scan number, the number of comparisons will become the inner loop. So for I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n minus 1, I told you this one, and I plus plus. And for j is equal to 1, j less than equal to n minus I told you this one, and j plus plus. If aj is greater than aj plus 1, if this particular data is greater than this, or this particular data is greater than this, so if aj is greater than aj plus 1, then swap aj aj plus 1. So in this way, the things are taking shape. Now what is swapping? Swapping means interchanging of two variables value. So that is known as a swapping. So I'm just assuming that there will be one swap function, or there is a swap command with the help of which I can easily do the swapping. If the corresponding function or the command is not available in the respective implementing language, then I shall have to write those three famous lines. So these are the three famous lines, that is temp is equal to aj, aj is equal to aj plus 1, and aj plus 1 is equal to temp. In this way, I can replace this swap aj, aj plus 1 using these three lines. Okay, obviously, they must be put in some curly braces as a block. So in this way, the program can work, or the algorithm can work. Okay, now see, in case of Java, in case of C programming, we are having array subscript starting from not 1 but from 0. In those cases, just put minus 1, just put minus 1, just put j in place of j, just put j minus 1, just put minus 1, that means j plus 1 minus 1, so it will become j. So just put minus 1 additional with the subscript values, you can easily convert it to the respective C or Java program. Here I have written only the algorithm. Okay, it is C like algorithm. Okay, so now in this way, my bubble sort program is working. Now, in the first scan, we are dealing with the n number of data. So how many comparisons did I require? I require 5 comparisons, that is n minus 1. In the second scan, n minus 2. In the last scan, how many comparisons did I do? 1. So what will be the sum of this series? If I go on calculating the number of comparisons required, because number of comparisons is the prime operation in this particular bubble chart. So that's why I'm just counting this one as n into n plus 1 n into n minus 1 whole by 2. And which is nothing but big O of n square. So, which is nothing but big O of n square. So, that means that bubble shot is having a complexity of n square. So, in this way, in this particular session, we have discussed what is a bubble shot and the respective algorithm. Obviously, this particular bubble shot is having one lacking. So, what is the lacking it is having? So, we will be discussing that one in the next video, where we are going to discuss modified bubble shot. Please watch that one, because that is also in the continuation of this one. Thanks for watching this video.